I'm going to try to get this thing hooked up, pick it up with the MX-6000, tip it up on its side to work on it. We'll see how this one goes. Okay, I've got most of the weight tilted towards the back here. And we should be in pretty good shape, safety-wise. Okay. Show you what happened here. You can see the pan has totally broken away. So the first thing I'm going to do is take the blades off, drop this pan, and then we've got to get this yoke off. Alrighty, I'm going to get started. Okay, let's take a look at this thing. It's a mess. I'm gonna get some pry bars. See if I can pry that thing off. We got one side off. Looks like I got one piece I want to hang up. We go. Okay, let's get this cotter pin out, get this nut off of here, and see if we can get this all taken apart. Well, let's just juice this up a little bit. I know it's not penetrating lubricant. We'll see if the good old WD-40 will do it. I picked up a cheap little puller and gear puller, and let's see if we can get that hooked up on here.
Let's try this contraption first. The most it can do is not work. Propane torch can get enough heat on it.
Okay, what I ended up doing, I didn't video a lot of it, is I just cut a slot and drove a air chisel up in it. I didn't want to apply too much heat because of the seal, and just use the hammer until she came off. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit of Neverseize on these splines so this doesn't happen again, because that's crazy, you know, getting on that that tight. That hole, even out here in all this daylight. Like it's a little bit of slag on there. Well, let's knock everything down. What I don't knock down, I drop. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna clean this up a little bit, you know, while I got it tipped up, and pick the tools up and we'll test it out. Okay, we got the machines ready to go again for this week. Latimer, are you ready? Laddie, you ready to go to work? You're always ready for work. Work on sleeping.